to create a web app with the HTML service, your code must include a doGet function that tells the script how to serve the page. The function must return an HTML output object. Save and give a name for your project. Now let's create the HTML file. Within the HTML file, you can write most standard HTML, CSS, and client-side JavaScript. Now, save a version of your script, then deploy your script as a web app. Select the project version. Select with which permission the application should run. Select who should be allowed to visit it. This URL is for the published version of your app, based on the last version you saved and deployed. Let's create this user interface. This link runs the most recently saved code and is intended for quick testing during development. Add styles to HTML elements to achieve this result. Now, add an event listener that fires when a user clicks the button. The document method getElementById returns an element object representing the element whose id property matches the specified string. DawSomething is the function we want to call when the event occurs. Now let's write the code for the DawSomething function. We start with the declaration of the variables. Then, we retrieve the values of the text fields and we assign them to these variables. Google Script Run is an asynchronous client-side JavaScript API that allows HTML service pages to call server-side apps script functions. Now write in code.js the code of the user clicked function. We want to store the data, first name, and last name in a spreadsheet. To do this, create a spreadsheet in Google Drive. Copy the URL link from the spreadsheet to insert it into the user clicked function code. Open by URL opens the spreadsheet with the given URL. The method appendRow appends a row to the spreadsheet. This code requires authorization. The easiest way to authorize the script is to run the user click function manually from the script editor once before loading the page. Let's give names for the columns. We want to empty these text boxes after inserting the data in the spreadsheet. Let's add the code for inserting the date in the spreadsheet. Note that HTML, CSS and JavaScript are included together in a single file. We will separate this file into three files: HTML, CSS and JavaScript.